this band and the members that he's had over the years have all been really, really loyal. Sam wanted you, his audience, to have the very best that he could provide. He wanted it to sound like you heard it on the radio or like the recording that you bought. It was pretty hard for the band sometimes to have it be that precise. But he loved you and he respected his audiences. And we thank you, and we thank you for the love.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Let's give it up for this band, huh? Ronnie Sam's band. I got to say something right quick, ladies and gentlemen, if it's okay. I know my time is short, but I have to let you know this. Y'all probably looking at me, don't know who I am, where I came from, and why I'm here. But Mighty Sam was one of my best friends, one of my closest friends. And it was like around in the 1990s, 2000, I heard the song on the radio, and I said, oh my God, who is that singing like that? So you know how radio is, they never tell you the artist. So I called the radio station, I said, who was that singing? And they said, that was Mighty Sam McClain. So the next day I ran out and bought every CD I could find on Mighty Sam McClain. So maybe 3 months later after that, I seen it. Sam was going to perform it in Chicago at Buddy Guy's Legends. And Sam never really performed in Chicago, so I got to go see him. But I had a festival to do that day, and Bloomington, Illinois was maybe a couple hours from Chicago, so I drove like crazy after my gig to get back. And long story short, I caught the second set, and I mean, they were slamming. They were smoking. And so I was in the VIP section. I walked up to him, and he was